Good morning, class. I'm back with the gradebook assignment, which is lab project number 6. You will find the assignments in the assignment deposit folder, and I would like you to open the file. Make sure you click on enable editing. And here, what I want you to do is simply just look at the roster. This is a class roster for Professor Mary's BTF 101 course. And there are about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 students. The 8 students have exam 1, exam 2, quiz 1, quiz 2, project 1, project 2. Basically, you need to get the total points, the course points alignment, as well as the final grades. So, of course, we're not going to use any calculator. We will be using strictly the Excel application to determine what will be the numerical figures. So, let's first count how we will decide the course points. In terms of deciding the course points, A is of course the 90% of the total points, and the total point is 500. The total point is 500 of this course, and so that's how we will decide. In terms of deciding the course points, we're going to start with an equal symbol and then 0.9 times 500, which is 450. Similarly, B is 80%. So again, equal symbol, 0.8 times 500. C is 70%, equal 0.7 times 500. That's going to be 350. And then D is, again, equal symbol, which is 60%, 0.6 times 500. And the last one is anything below 300, which is considered as the letter F. So here you can do as close as letter D, which is again equal 0.599 times 500, which will be as close as, like, you know, below 300. So that's the first step, which we're going to assign the course points. Second is the total points earned. In the total points earned, we are going to simply do the auto sum. And here is how you are going to select the auto sum. First, you need to make sure that you click on the total points earned, which is corresponding to Sarah's total points. So here you click on it once and then click on the auto sum. And then as soon as you click on the auto sum, these are the numerical figures that are detected. You make sure from which cell to which cell, which is from C to H, and then press enter, 433. The rest of the cells you can simply copy to the rest of the formulas, which is, since, like, you know, simply just, you know, drag it, release the mouse, and the rest of the cells are configured. Now comes the final grade points. Of course, final grade points, you can simply assign the letters, but let's imagine that we are dealing with many rows and columns. So we will not be able to determine the final grades like that, but we have to ensure we are using the formula. How we can use the formula? We are going to use the if formula. So we're going to start with an equal symbol, if, an open bracket, and in this case, which is I5 greater than or equal to, and then we are going to assign the dollar symbol, and this case we need to assign, which is A is equal to 450. So, which is the D, and then again dollar symbol, which is D18. Okay, then we are going to insert a comma, and then inside the equal symbol we will assign the letter grade A. Okay, so I know it's kind of a little bit complicated, but again, you know, as long as you are being patient and understanding the whole reasoning point, you were going to get a sense how you can use the if formula. So basically, what I have done is, if in the open bracket, I5 greater than or equal to dollar D and dollar 18. If you have remembered in our last assignments, I have discussed about how you should be able to make the cell constant. In this case, we need to make this cell constant because these won't change. That's one of the reasons. So after the A, inside the quotation, we're going to put a comma, and then we will repeat this 5 times because there are 5 letter grades. So again, very similarly, we're going to start with if, open bracket, I5, and then greater than or equal to, again, dollar symbol, D, and this time not 18, this time is 19. So again, dollar symbol D and dollar symbol 19, comma, inside the quotation, letter B. Make sure you close the quotation. Right after the quotation, you're going to insert the comma, and then we're going to start with the if, open bracket, I5, greater than or equal to the dollar symbol D, and then this time the D19, so D and then dollar symbol 19, sorry, 20, and comma inside the quotation, letter grade C. Okay, once again, comma, because we need to do 2 more. So IF inside the bracket, I5 greater than or equal to dollar symbol D and then dollar symbol 21, because the D is 21, and then comma. This time we're going to assign the letter grade D. Doesn't matter if it's small letter or capital letter. So comma, now we're doing the last part. Last part is very interesting. At the same time, you should understand the logic behind it. You can do it in multiple ways, but I'm going to just show you once. So again, let's start with if inside the bracket, I5 less than or equal to, because this time we need to, anything is below 300 considered as letter F. So this, the below 300 is what? The D21, right? So we are going to assign the dollar symbol D and then dollar symbol 21 one more time. And then comma inside the quotation, letter F, and that's it. So this time we don't need to put comma anymore because we're done. So what we did, again, if you look at this situation here, if I5 greater than or equal to D18 inside the quotation, if it's true, then the student gets A. If again, I5 greater than or equal to D19, if it's true, the student will get B. I5 is greater than or equal to D20, the student will get C. Or if I5 is greater than or equal to D21, then the student gets D. And the last one is, this time I'm going to put less than or equal to, because anything is below D, the student will get an F. Now, in order to finish it up, I'm going to end it with adding 5 brackets, because we have opening 5 brackets. So in terms of closing it, we're going to do it 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then press enter. So this gives me the letter B. Now, imagine you have to do the rest of them. Of course, you know, it's kind of confusing, and I will encourage you to complete it. But the shortcut is, because we did the first one, you can simply copy to the rest of the cell. And that's going to give you the answers. Okay. So I hope you find it interesting. At the same time, make sure you learn how to get the if formula done. And once completed, make sure you upload it.